Hello and welcome to Star Trek Online. My name is P52 Smith. And today we are back on the Tribble Test Server, as you can tell by the strange and interesting my login screen. This is a highly intensive bloom going on here. I'm kind of hoping this is a little over the top right now, because my bloom setting is 10%. And that's a lot of bloom, and this is all very bright and things. But that's not really why we're here. As for that, good grief. But yeah, we are here today because if you didn't know and haven't already guessed, Star Trek Online has a brand new expansion on the way. The Delta Rising expansion is coming. And it's been working its way onto Tribble for a little while now. Most of the updates have included story missions, that kind of thing. Or stuff behind level gated elements which require you to be level 54, level 60. Because, oh yeah, the level cap's being raised. I tend not to like putting a huge amount of time into Tribble in that kind of regard. Also, all my characters here are level 50. Now, although they have added a thing that allows you to gain one level up per day, I've avoided that. So this is a slightly out of date copy of my characters. This is before they added the Odyssey uniform into the main game, but that's not an issue because we are here today to look at the new Intrepid Refit model, which I already have active as you saw in space. This is the Cochrane model, or something very much like it, and we now have the brand new and much sexier looking Intrepid, which if you ask me, it looks an awful lot better than the current one on holodeck, which I'll be putting on screen for you to have a direct comparison against. And to make that kind of thing easier, we'll go to maximum zoom, we're on the default Intrepid settings, and we'll face it to the right. You can see all the lovely little shapes, so it's been rounded, this lovely underside is now just how it's supposed to be. We'll go for the top-down view, or maybe not. Ah, good grief. Oh, the rear view, of course, the rear view. Which I don't think is a huge amount different on the whole. Front view has obviously been changed because of this new section under here. Yeah, that's not quite what I had in mind. What I really want is... where is it? That kind of view. It's very hard to actually rotate these things in a very specific manner. There we go. So there is our top-down Intrepid. Main thing to note is how much of an angle this thing now comes back at rather than just diving in like it used to. Now I do still have a couple of minor niggles with this model. One of which actually is this escape pod here. That just kind of works. Looks weird from top down, but it kind of works, I suppose. But the escape pods, they don't quite look right like that to me. I'm not sure if it's just something I'm misremembering from Voyager or what, but those are the escape pods, and currently they are completely unchangeable, which is a thing. Material options is defaulted to type 2, which is okay. We have all the other type 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 and veteran options, which actually kind of nice the way these get much wider as it comes to the front. That really actually looks very well done. The problem I do have with this model is comes when we start putting on hull patterns. The Andromeda pattern, a little bit better type 2 to be fair, the Andromeda pattern is much nicer than it used to be. I should put it to all black to highlight where it is. Now the original one used to have a thick old band down here, which again I'll put on screen so you can see properly. This new one's got this lovely just little accent down there, highlighted at the edge of the saucer and a little bit underneath around here. That's awesome. These extra bits down the back, I quite like that. If, and only if, it continues onto the hull. Which that bit does, these bits just stop. That needs a fix. Crypt it. Quickly. Fix it. Match that bit, please. Please, for all our sakes. Again, the hull, Otherwise, just a nice little accent around the back here, filled in that bit across the pylon joins, and a little bit around the defector. That's quite nice. Just makes things look a little bit more awesome. The nacelle options are a little all-encompassing, if I'm honest, but that does kind of still work somehow, to my way of looking at this. And then the pylons themselves will get just a little touch of highlight to fill in that line along the back. And to be honest, that actually does look quite nice on the whole. It's just this bit that just stops arbitrarily. And you can tell it's already joined the hull at that point, but ugh. So that is the Intrepid model. The other thing to note actually quickly is the aero shuttle underneath, and that has its own customizey thingy. Makes it look like that, which is quite nice. Does kind of make me wonder whether it's actually going to become a separatable thing at some point, but we will see. One important thing to note, there have been no patch notes for this yet, to my knowledge. I've been checking the Tribble notes and I've not seen anything to do with this. So when I logged on and went to check and found it was here, I was highly surprised. Which does also lead me to hope that this is still slightly work in progress and that things like that are going to get a touch up, because that's no need for that. That can just sort of go into a straight line and catch up with this bit can perhaps curve up slightly or just follow in a straight line to go to there. That's actually quite easy to fix. Actually, how well does that work if we put the Cochrane hull? Discovery hull. Oh dear, that really doesn't work. You can tell where the overlaps have changed. Oh dear. Anyway, we'll have a look at the Cochrane in its default appearance. Important to note, we can't change these logos anymore on these models. The Intrepid one doesn't have a fleet logo anymore, so we can't change them. Thank you! So we have the Cochrane, which we'll put on a side view and a top view. I may miss that slightly. So we have the Cochrane, which I think still looks pretty much as it used to do. These nacelles are still the old style black bar. The escape pods and winners, again, we can't change. They're stuck at this setting, which is different to the Intrepid ones, but they are... Admittedly, it's one of the nice settings in the default, too, for the escape pods. I don't quite remember some of these lines on here. I'll have a picture of this alongside to compare. But we do have the aero shuttle underneath now, which also has its own customization option still. Which also leads me to think, is this going to become a thing? So that is the Cochrane. And then of course we have the Discovery, which again still looks very much like it did, though I don't quite remember this being quite that bendy. I got memories of this coming down much more steeply and dropping out. So I think that's been modified slightly to match the new bend options. Because they all kind of fit together, just Intrepid also that doesn't line up with these things. That's a thing. So this is the Discovery. Again, I think this is more or less unmodified. Although we do, have our aero shuttle docked underneath as well. They might have changed little under here, I don't know. I'll have pictures so you'll be able to see much more easily and more readily what has and has not happened. So that is a quick look at the Intrepid in the ship Taylor. What we will do now is go back to Intrepid, and because I do actually quite like it, I'm going to go to black, and oops, that's not black, that's black, and I will put the Andromeda settings back on, because apart from this little defect down here, actually it works quite well. It's subtle enough to hint at what's going on, but there actually is enough of it to make a decent difference. So that's that, that's all that. Bridges seem to have vanished. That's probably just because the sea store is currently closed. So we'll leave those as they are. We haven't got the Intrepid bridge on here yet. That's a thing that will happen if it ever does. And we will... Oh, let's have a look at the hull materials with the patterns. That kind of looks interesting. I'll go for type 5, which is kind of my general favourite. So there we go. I do have the Bellerophon model unlocked on holodeck, and did time I copied this character over. I think I was using at least part of it when I did it, but it's all vanished. I'm hoping that's just Tribble with the sea store closed and things like that happening, and not an intent to remove them, because that'll be bad. So let's head back up to Sol System and take a look at the Intrepid with my slight modifications in space. And there she is, fading into the shadows. So the escape pods don't look quite so bad in space. Obviously these little red corner brackets I was seeing, but there's still something just not quite right about them, I don't know. The problem up here is there's all shadowies around, so getting a decent look at the back is difficult. But that's okay, because what we want to do now, that's not such an important thing. Because the ablative armour console has, or I believe is due, to be modified for each of the three skins. At the moment, however, it still appears exactly the same as it does on holodeck. Just like that. They have actually carved some channels into the front of this nacelle, actually, for the new model. But otherwise, that is basically as it is seen on holodeck. And those windows have had squares around them, that's not good. The only difference is with the Cochrane and Discovery models, on holodeck at the moment, there's a bit of reshaping and stuff that happens to them when they go around the saucer and any bulky bit around the back. Particularly on the inside of the Cochrane, it's obvious what happens. But that's been fixed. Oh my goodness, that's a lot of flashing lights. I'm sure they should be. And these should be a lot big, these should be a lot bigger than that. But that, oh, that's beautiful. That's nice. Thank you, Cryptic. Well done. On the whole, a good modification. A couple of minor niggles you can't really see in this amount of space, but pretty good, all told. What I will do is skip ahead slightly and bring the Cochrane back up here with the same hull options, exactly the same everything, and show you the ablative generator as it stands here on Tribble. And so here we have the Cochrane out in Solar System. That's what we look like. And now if we activate the ablative generator, that really, really doesn't work anymore, and it just doesn't fit. That bit is as is, but otherwise, ugh. Seriously hoping this is still requiring an overview, because that just does not work. But yeah, this is the Intrepid Refit section on Tribble, which I'm still hoping very much work in progress. If not, boy oh boy, we got some problems. I am going to be making a forum post listing my concerns, so hopefully we'll get some dev attention on that, and I will link that to here and this to that, and we'll have a bit of cross-linking round in circles going on. But yeah, all good fun. Intrepid Refit on Tribble, ahead of Delta Rising, which releases on the 14th of October. My name has been P52 Smith, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.